Hey everyone, welcome back to another Shift Gears, Drink Beers. Today we're going to be talking about the TPI ECU Reflash. So if your bike sounds like this, or maybe this, then this video is definitely for you. From the factory, these TPI engines and maps are built around the European emissions law, Euro 4, which comes with a few notable issues. Number one, we have a pretty lean running motor, particularly from idle to about half throttle. Number two, we get excessive pipe bang on deceleration. I know I've personally experienced that and it's just pretty annoying. I don't know what the performance issue is or if it leads to a performance issue. And number three, probably the most important, is our bikes use a very small amount of oil, which can lead to durability problems. Number four, and another common complaint with these TPI bikes, is the performance just feels a bit flat, especially when comparing it to another carbureted two-stroke. And lastly, the bike is hard to start. So now that we're all on the same page with the problem, let's talk about the potential advantages of reflashing your ECU and why you might want to do this. Number one, we get much better engine performance from idle to half throttle, going right in line with issue number one. Number two, smoother power delivery. We can all probably agree TPIs have a rather smooth power delivery as it is when comparing that to any other two-stroke on the market. Number three, they're claiming we get more torque from low to mid RPMs. Number four, less pipe bang on deceleration. And number five, richer air fuel ratios. Number six, and probably the most important of all of these, is additional oil injection. More oil leads to a happier bike and a happier rider. Pretty straightforward stuff if you're familiar at all with this issue. These are pretty common complaints that you've probably read online or anywhere else. However, I had a very unique issue with my bike. I tried troubleshooting it all over the place, really had no luck. I took another stock 2020 ECU, put in my bike, and did not have that issue. You might have heard at the beginning, my bike was revving out. I couldn't do anything other than to shut it off for it to come down in the revs. I don't know, it sounded like the throttle was almost stuck wide open, but it wasn't.
Dude.
It happened to me on multiple days, so I know for a fact that that wasn't the issue. I'm actually pretty excited because I have now an aftermarket ECU flash on my bike. I have probably about 10 hours on this thing now from all different types of terrain. I've done some hard enduro, some big rocks, some hill climbs, some more wide open stuff, fourth, fifth gear. So I've done it all. This particular map that I went with, I'm not gonna say the name of it. If you're interested, drop me a message on Instagram or drop a comment below, and happy to share that with you. I'm not sponsored by them. However, if you would like to be, let me know. With this particular aftermarket ECU, you're able to run three maps come stock from it. The first one being an enduro map, second one being an all-around trail map, and then an MX map. And then lastly, it's completely customizable. In a future video, I'm gonna look to run all three maps back to back. So the enduro, the trail, and an MX map. And we'll do this on kind of an interesting course where, you know, we'll start on the MX track, hit like some open stuff on the trails, and then into some hard enduro stuff, or semi-hard enduro, whatever. And run each one of those maps and see how they perform. So if you're familiar at all with the GYTR tuner, it's kind of like that, except you need a computer to do it rather than a little handheld. So KTM hasn't really come along that far yet, but I am happy to report that I love this map. It is one of my favorite upgrades I've done to my bike, probably outside of the RK Tech head. I know a lot of people like two-stroke performance, very similar to that. I just personally went with the RK Tech head. So my bike has a lot of aftermarket parts on it right now. This is not just, you know, a stock bike that I've loaded this map on. I've done the head, I've done the idle adjustment screw, along with countless other upgrades to the bike. And I probably shouldn't mention what those upgrades are or how much they cost in case my wife watches this. Overall, going through some of those issues, yeah, I did really have some of them. The pipe bang on deceleration, little bit of a throttle sputter. I have replaced my crankcase pressure sensor a couple times now. The one that I really noticed was that performance in like the mid to high RPMs as well. I noticed myself shifting less actually, which is strange. This is a 250 XCW and I was shifting all the time. And anyone with a 250 probably knows that. So I'll try to keep this short. My opinion on it, I absolutely love it. I'm riding the 250 and I'm gonna do everything I can to get more power out of it. I would still choose the 250 over the 300s because I think it's a little bit more fun. It's personal preference. Yes, the 300 is probably a better bike for hard enduro, pretty much anything. But for me, yeah, absolutely. I feel it coming out of corners. I feel it whenever you're trying to climb a hill, you just get a little bit more of that low end torque. And honestly, it's great. Hopefully this video helped you in making your decision if you wanted to go and move forward with an aftermarket or even just taking your bike to the KTM dealer and getting the ECU reflashed. But for me, absolutely great upgrade. I would recommend it to anyone, just like the head replacement as well as the idle adjustment screw. Those are almost three key things that you want to do to your bike outside of your standard other upgrades. Stick around for a future video of us running the maps back to back to back to see if we can really notice any difference in the performance of them. Drop a comment and let me know if you've already reflashed your ECU or went with an aftermarket one, why you did that, curious to hear. And I'm also really curious to know if anybody else had that revving out issue, like that clip I played a little bit earlier. I don't know if that was unique to me or my bike, whatever, but this fixed it. So really happy with that, let me know. Thank you again for watching. Remember to like, subscribe, share, comment, tell your friends. I appreciate all the support that has recently come to my channel. It seems to be growing pretty well. So thank you very much for that. And I'll catch you in the next one.
Peace.